discuss about refraction of light practically. I will show you some examples. So assume that this is a transparent glass. Okay, so here we are going to learn refraction of light at curved surface. So I have considered this glass, which is having, see, this part is curved. If you observe, if you touch this, you will observe it is a curved part. Okay, so now what happens? So see here, this glass, so outside of this glass it is all air, and here inside also you will observe nothing is there. So this is also inside air is present. Okay, so now assume that this pen has a light ray. So when it travels from air to the glass, so glass is another medium, air is a different medium. So what happened, this pen, the light ray of the pen, assume this is a light ray, it will bend and travels. Now I will consider, so this is a water, I was pouring the water into this glass. Okay, are you able to observe it clearly? Okay, see here, this is a curved surface. Now, so the separation of the two mediums, so assume that, so here I will draw the diagram. Let us draw the diagram of this picture on the board. So the curved surface, so this is the curved surface, I will draw like this. So if you observe, the curved, this is the curve. So this curve I will draw like this. Okay, you understand? So if I make completes again, it will become a circle like this glass. So now, so outside, assume that this part is outside, this outside. So this is air, I will consider air. Okay, and inside what you observe, you have water. So observe the structure of the water. Water is also in curved path only. So assume that this water, I will draw here. So this is the water which is present in the glass, and this medium, the separation of these two, air and water. So this is the separation of two mediums. You understand? Okay, this is the water now. So water, I have it is shaded because the density is more than air. Okay, so do you understand now? So this is the diagram of this glass on the board. Okay, now see here. Suppose consider this as a, here you will observe, this is a structure, this is a structure. Okay, now let us observe the diagram. So this is the structure, a diagram here I have drawn. So this is the curved surface you consider this part curved. Okay, so this is a curved surface, and outside you have air, and inside I have shown you already, inside you have the water. So this is the water, which is denser medium. Now assume that for this curved surface, consider this as a light ray. So a light ray is coming and it was striking over here, and assume that another light ray is coming and it was striking here. So many light rays will come and it will strike the curved surface. Okay, so it will meet the curved surface at some point. So assume that this point, so some light rays will come in this direction also, some light rays may come in this direction. So all from all the directions the light rays will come and it will strike the curved surface. So what here is, I have considered four light rays, and they are striking, or they are touching the curved surface at these points. Okay, so what is this C? C is called center of curvature. So what is C? Assume that here you can observe, this is the curved, this is a spherical part, this is a sphere structure, or this side I will show. If I locate the midpoint here, and this midpoint is called as center of curvature. Understand? So that is I have located. Now, and this is the surface of the, or curved part of the sphere. If I locate, suppose if I consider, if I divide this like this, I have made curved, only this curved part. Here we have considered like this, so this curved part. Suppose if I locate the midpoint on the sphere, so midpoint, this is a midpoint, and this midpoint is called as pole, for only for this half part. Midpoint of the sphere is center of curvature, and on the sphere, that is the pole. Okay, so if you join these two, pole and center of curvature, so what we call it as? We call it as principal axis. So this is called principal axis. Understand? Now, see here. Suppose if I draw a line from center of curvature. See, I will draw a line from center of curvature to this point. Okay. So from center of curvature to, I am drawing the line from center of curvature to this point.